इट्स पेज नंबर 26. Defarge pulled the ragged curtain slightly. The old man on the bench was now clearly visible. He had a long white beard and a pale hollow face with very bright blue eyes. His shirt lay open at the neck, and it was possible to see that his body was all bone with just a thin layer of skin covering it. He put up a hand to his eyes and the bones seemed almost transparent. Defarge approached him. So when M. Defarge pulled the ragged curtains slightly, they all the people who were present in that room, Mr. Lorry, Miss Manet and M. Defarge, they are able to see a clear image of Dr. Manet. Now the Dr. Manet is clearly visible to all of them. Dr. Manet, he had a long white beard. His face became pale and his eyes were bright blue. But he became so weak that he seems like a structure of bones under thin layer of skin. So Defarge was the first person who again Defarge is the same person who is approaching Dr. Manet. You have a visitor. What's that? A visitor. The shoemaker looked up towards the man Defarge was pointing to. He did not let go of the shoe he was walking on. So Defarge, he informed Dr. Manet that some visitor is there and the visitor wanted to see him. It is for the first time that Dr. Manet looked upward to see the visitor. That is a fine shoe. Show it to the gentleman. Mr. Lorry looked carefully at the shoe. What kind of shoe is it, sir? The old man thought for a moment. What's that? The shoe? Who is it for? Who made it? It is a young lady's walking shoe. Defarge repeated Mr. Lorry's last question. And the maker's name? So after that, M. Defarge introduced Mr. Lorry to Dr. Manet by pointing out towards him. Mr. Lorry started talking with Dr. Manet by asking him about what kind of shoe it is and it is for whom and who made it, like this. So Dr. Manet, he said that it is a shoe, but he was unable to give the answers of all the questions one by one. So M. Defarge repeated the last question of Mr. Lorry and the maker's name. After that, then he asked him his name, but Dr. Manet, he was not able to give the answer. So he remained calm for a moment. There was a silence for a moment while the old man's empty eyes tried to look out through the windows of his inner world. Did you ask for my name? I did. 105 North Tower. Is that all? 105 North Tower. After becoming silent for some moment, Dr. Manet, he said to them, Are you people asking about my name? Mr. Lorry said, yes. Then he said, 105 North Tower. Mr. Lorry again repeated his questions. Is that all? He again gave the same answer. Instead of his name, he was just giving a reference of some 105 North Tower. So from this conversation, we come to know that because of the imprisonment, Dr. Manet, he became physically weak and mentally ill. So weak that and mentally so unstable, he became mentally so unstable that he even forgot his own name. Thank you.